Hi everyone, we're here at Devoxx 2014. I'm here with Martin.
Hello everyone.
Hi Martin, and we're here to talk about Polymer because you have been very busy at this conference advocating Polymer.
And a lot of people were there to see it. There is a lot of interest around Polymer today.
I think indeed there was a lot of interest. But so what are people interested and why do you think they're interested? What is Polymer and how does it fit in the, we're talking about web here and taking the web forward.
So taking just a little step back, the important thing here is web components. That's the standard evolving and allowing you to use and create components that you will be able to import into your page and that are self-contained, encapsulated, have a proper interface. Well, everything you have been used to in higher level languages for years, but this did not exist in HTML. Finally, the standard is evolving to bring this back. You will be able to have libraries of components built using various technologies. You don't care, it just works. It doesn't break your page. You put them in, boom.
And so we're talking about in source code using tags, which are the implementation. So as a user of those components, it's very easy. It's tags, attributes, and you're done.
It's easier than that. It's one tag. A web component is one tag. You have a special button that someone created for you with beautiful animations and your company colors and whatever. To use it in your page, you just use one tag, which is my custom button.
Okay. So web components is actually multiple specs, am I right? And that is specification, by the way. This is not a Google thing. This is we're talking
exactly.
Something.
Exactly. It's four specifications, shadow DOM, template, custom element, and I always forget one. Shadow DOM, template.
Template. Thank you. So these are something that is agreed upon among a number of vendors, and that makes up the web components. And then at Google, obviously, we talk a lot about material design. And obviously, there's probably an intersection here between material design, building things for the web, and having this unified way of building and UI, UX.
So material design is a design philosophy. I encourage everyone to go and check out google.com/design. It's all there, and frankly, I find it a fascinating read. It reads like a novel. It's all the philosophy of material design.
And you're more of a developer than a designer. It's probably worth mentioning that it is good for developers to read this.
Exactly. It is. All developers should be design-minded, and it's a great resource for developers who want to become design-minded. And it just happens that Polymer, which allows the building of reusable components, comes with a library of paper components, which are based on the principles of material design. It's there. Try them out.
Yeah, so Polymer is the web implementation of what Android Lollipop is bringing in terms of an implementation of material design.
Exactly. Polymer is actually two things. Polymer at its core is a set of polyfills because the web standards we were talking about, they are not yet supported everywhere, so the Polymer polyfill brings all browsers to the same level.
Okay.
This hopefully will go away one day. And on top of that, there is the value added of Polymer, which is basically syntactic sugar to make the building and using of components a more enjoyable experience for the developer.
Okay, tell us more about that enjoyable experience of building the component itself.
So one way to see it is, first, if you hear about those four specifications, import, template, shadow DOM, and the fourth one, which I keep forgetting. actually, creating your own custom element using the new low-level JavaScript requires, it's not so complicated, but it does require quite a few lines of JavaScript. It's not so simple. So what Polymer brings is a syntax using tags that allows you to define your own component. And that is a lot more usable than the low-level JavaScript. It's too much work. It's nothing fancy, but it's too much work using the low-level JavaScript.
Okay, so take the boilerplate out of the way. So once I have those components, am I forcing anybody who wants to use one of my components to use Polymer? You know, I'm using all sorts of JavaScript libraries and frameworks and all that. Does it play well with all those things?
Well, that's the beauty. Those web components, you can build them using whatever technology, whatever framework is there that produces web components. When a user will import this component into his page, once the JavaScript that handles all the syntactic sugar is executed, at the end of the day, that component ends up in the DOM as a web component that the browser understands natively. Mm-hmm. So this means that you will be able to mix and match components built using various frameworks, and they will work, and the fact that they are proper components encapsulated, their HTML is encapsulated, their CSS is encapsulated, the JavaScript that defines their behavior is encapsulated, they will not break your page. They should not interfere with each other. They should not interfere with the other libraries you're using.
So encapsulation is great, but at some point you need to interact with it and not just use it. Are there ways to customize this and expose parts of the implementation?
Exactly. They have a customizable surface, but one that you define. So the simplest way is to define custom attributes, and you specify what these attributes are going to do in your component. For instance, you can have a heading attribute in a component, and the definition of the component will display that heading somewhere as the CSS and the HTML of this component defines it.
And so, from what you're saying, I mean, this is the web in terms of use any tool you want, any framework you want. We're not forcing people with Polymer to use a new framework and have this dependency or use this set of tools or a tool chain. You're really still using whatever framework you want, and at the end of the day, this is all, web pages.
I do believe that in a couple of years, there will be multiple frameworks for generating web components. Polymer is one. Mozilla is creating one, actually based on the same polyfills, which means that even now, before web components are fully implemented in browsers, since they use the same polyfills, those elements will be compatible even now.
That's great. So how mature is this whole thing? Web components, we're using those polyfills now. But that's certainly a very viable thing.
It's very bleeding edge right now. You can look up the support for the four specs on Can I Use. The short version is that those specs are implemented fully on Chrome only, and they are under various stages of implementation on other browsers. So that's totally bleeding edge. It doesn't work today in a cross-browser environment. The polyfills themselves in Polymer, so Polymer itself is in version 0.4, which means that the polyfills and their cross-browser support is in the same kind of state. I would not put it into production today. Of course, you should wait for a 1.0 to put anything into production.
Right.
But the promise is that
there are breaking changes, right?
Exactly. There are still breaking changes, but the promise is once Polymer reaches 1.0, those polyfills should be stable. The libraries of elements that come with Polymer should be stable, and you will be able to deploy web components cross-browser thanks to the polyfills.
That sounds pretty promising. So in the meantime, you were running a code lab here, which I believe is available online, which people can follow
at
their own pace. So we'll have links to in the show notes to that. And I think that's probably something that people should check out and do on their own.
Please try it out. It's a very simple application. And in it, you can see how fast you can build something that looks great, because it uses the paper elements with material design behind it.
Great. So I hope you try this. You follow Polymer as it evolves, and start using it as soon as you find it mature enough for your needs. Thank you, Martin.
Thank you, Alexei.
And we'll be seeing you online. Cheers.